try to answer the following questions yourself first, and then you can see the video and use it to see whether your answers are correct and whether you have included all steps. So we have a function f of z over here, and question A, this f of z has a power series around z0 equals 3 plus 3i. And if it has, then find the maximum radius r, such as the power series converges to f of z in the open disk around z0. That's question A. And then question B, I determine the Lorentz series of this function for a norm of z between 2 and 3. Now, first question, this f of z has a power series around 3 plus 3i. Well, let's make a picture. F of z has singularities if z equals plus or minus 2i and if z equals 3. So the singularities are there and there and there. So that means that f of z is analytic in 3 plus 3i. So that means you can form a power series of f of z around 3 plus 3i. And this power series converges to f of z until you hit the first singularity. So where do we hit the singularity? Well, if we go downward, so at distance 3 we had a singularity. And if we go left and down, how far do we travel now? Well, 3 in this direction, 1 in that one, so a distance of square root of 10. So the first singularity we hit is actually here. So the maximal radius is this distance 3 to the first singularity. Now, question B. The Lorentz series in the annulus where the norm of z is between 2 and 3. So, first of all, what's the center of this Lorentz series? Well, let's make a picture. Annulus with radius 2 and annulus with radius 3. And we see they are annuli around the origin. So we have our center z0 equals 0. And we are looking for a power series which converges in this annulus over there. Now, let's try to form this Lorentz series. First solution, therefore, g of z equals, let's call 2 over 4 plus z squared g1 of z. And then let's try to form a geometric series out of this. So we take the factor 4 out and the minus sign, and we get over here. So the 2 over 4 equals 1 half, and we form a geometric series like this, and then we can simplify a bit. So there we have the Lorentz series of our g1 of z. However, there's something wrong here. What's wrong? Well, you have to be a bit careful here, because you only can form a geometric series like this if the norm of z squared over 4 is smaller than 1, so if the norm of z is smaller than 2. But norm of z smaller than 2 is over here. And that's not where we are forming our series. So in this case, the step 2 is not correct. So we have to do something different. Second try. Now we form f of z equals g1 plus g2. Where our g1 is again this term 2 over 4 plus z squared. Second try. We now take out the 2 over z squared like this. Then we are left with 1 over the 1 from this one minus minus 4 over z squared, like this. Now we can form the Lorentz series. We can expand this part over here. The minus 4 over z squared is minus 4 over z squared to the power n. And we can do so because the norm of minus 4 over z squared is indeed smaller than 1. Check. Is 4 indeed smaller than the norm of z squared? Yes, this is true, because the norm of z is bigger than 2. We were outside the disk with radius 2. So we can, and then we can simplify our g1 of z a bit. Minus 4 to the power n equals minus 1 to the power n times 2 to the power 2n. And then take this factor 2 in to get 2 to the power 2n plus 1. And in the denominator, you get z to the power 2n. And just take the z squared in to get the z to the power 2n plus 2. So there we have the Laurent series of our G1 offset. Are all steps now correct? Okay, now we are fine because we checked here that we were in the correct annulus. On to the second part, let's call it G2 offset, because minus z over z minus 3. Let's use a geometric series for this part as well. We take out the minus z over minus 3, so take the minus z in front, which is in the numerator, and take the minus 3 out, then you get a 1 over 1 minus z over 3. Then we use a geometric series. Minus z over minus 3 is z over 3. And 1 over 1 minus z over 3 becomes a sum n from 0 to infinity, z over 3 to the power n. And let's check, is this correct? Well, this is correct if the norm of z over 3 is less than 1. So if the norm of z is less than 3. And that's indeed the case because we were inside the disk with radius 3. Remember, we were in the disk with in the annulus with radii between 2 and 3. So this part is correct. And then we can simplify a bit. Z over 3 to the power n equals z to the power n over 3 to the power n, and just take in the z over 3. And there you have the Laurent series of your G2 offset. And now, combine everything. F offset is this first one, G1 offset, plus this second part, G2 offset. So we add the two up. So our conclusion, F offset equals G1 offset over here, plus G2 offset over there. And there we have the Laurent series of our function f of z in the annulus with norm of z bigger than 2 and norm of z less than 3.